In this particular question, there is a particular region in which magnetic field is present. There is a loop which enters this particular region. As soon as it enters, the part which is lying within this particular magnetic field that gets an EMF of V vector cross B vector, that is BLV in this direction. There is a current which flows, which tries to retard its motion. How? EMF will be equal to BLV, the current will be BLV upon R. So the force will be acting in this direction, that force will be BIL. Note that the rest of the part is not within the magnetic field, it doesn't experience any force. So the force becomes V square L square V by R. When the entire loop comes into the magnetic field, at that particular time, that this part also gets an EMF of BLV, this part also gets an EMF of BLV. The flux is constant, so that's why we can say there is no EMF, no current. When it is about to leave, at that time EMF is BLV again, and again we can say that the force is in the backward direction. That means the force does not change its direction. In between, the force becomes zero, but the force is always in this direction. It will try to retard. So, by taking force equal to mass into acceleration, m into v dv by dx, we can say this is v gets cancelled, and by integrating, we get v naught minus v equal to b square l square x by r. That means v and x have a linear dependence on each other. Current also has a direct linearly proportionality relationship with the velocity, so it is also having a linear relationship with x. And the force also has a linear relationship with the speed, velocity, so that's why force also has a linear dependence on x. But in the option number B, although the force is given as a linear relationship, but what they are saying is that the force is changing its direction, which cannot be correct because the force in both the cases is acting in the backward direction only. So that's why the only option which is correct is Calcutta and Delhi. In this particular question, photons of wavelength lambda VH are made to incident on this particular surface, and this emitter plate, the electrons are emitted. Now here, this particular collector plate is at a higher potential, that means the electrons are going to accelerate. The maximum kinetic energy of the emitted photons is given by h by lambda pH minus phi. So the kinetic energy of the electrons which are reaching the anode is h by lambda pH minus phi plus E into V. So lambda electrons, we know by the formula P equal to h by lambda, and P equal to root 2 mk, we can say lambda of the electrons is h by root 2 mk, which comes out to this critical value. Now in the question it is given in A option, let's check each and every option. EV is much greater than phi. So in that particular case, I can neglect this entire thing, hc by lambda pH minus phi. So the only prominent term is lambda E equal to h by 2 m EV. So if V is made 4 times, then approximately lambda E becomes half. If you look at B option, they say that lambda E increases at the same rate as lambda pH. As if it increases at the same rate, it doesn't seem to be increasing at the same rate because this is a term which is in the root, and so it is not increasing at the same rate. Lambda is approximately half, is D is double, where the distance D is something which does not figure at all in the equation because what is mattering is the potential difference. So D is not at all of importance. And D option says the lambda E decreases with increase in phi, with increase in phi and lambda pH. If we increase lambda pH, then what will happen, that this term will go less and this will increase, not decrease. So D option cannot be correct. Also, only option that can be correct is option A. In this question number 12, they asked for range for two galvanometers and two resistors where they are connected in different arrangements. In the first arrangement, in the option A, the maximum voltage range is obtained when all the components are connected in series. Two galvanometer and two resistors, they are connected in series. In this case, the voltage across the whole thing that is obtained as IG, which is the current through the galvanometer, because they are in series, all of them will have the same current, multiply 2R plus 2RC. That comes out to be 2IG into RC plus R. In the option B, if I look at that, the voltage range is when there are two resistances are connected in series and two galvanometers are connected in parallel. Since this branch gets IG plus IG, so this branch gets 2IG. So the voltage drop over here becomes 2IG into, in this branch the resistance equivalent becomes RC by 2, and in this branch the resistance becomes 2R, which I can write as 2IG into RC plus R plus RC minus R minus RC by 2. I'll just rearrange that. Now if you look at that, this is RC plus R and this is also RC plus R. This is R minus RC by 2, and we can say over here that R minus RC by 2 will always be positive because RC happens to be less than So this thing is going to be greater than the upper value. So option B is correct, A is not correct. The maximum current range ke baare mein agar pucha jaye, so they say that in option C, maximum current is obtained when all the components are connected in parallel. Here all the components are connected in parallel, R, R, RC and RC. So obviously in this branch, calorimeter branch, the current is IG. When the current in this branch is IG, then because this has a current IG, so this has a potential difference of IG into RC. So the current in this branch becomes IG into RC upon R. In this branch also IG into RC by R. So the range of current, total current, is 2IG into 1 plus RC by R. Let's look at the option number D. There they say maximum current range is obtained when two galvanometers are connected in series and the combination is connected in parallel with both the resistors. Obviously, again the galvanometers will carry a current of IG. The current in both of them will be, here the potential drop will be IG into RC, here the potential drop will be IG into RC. So total potential drop becomes 2IG into RC. So current in this branch is 2IG into RC divided by R, and same is current over here. The total current in this becomes IG plus the current in these two branches, that is IG plus 4IG RC by R. If we rearrange them, then becomes 2IG into half plus RC by R plus RC by R. Now if you look at that, this particular thing RC by R, question mein diya gaya hai ki RC by R is less than half. So this particular thing RC by R plus half, this will be less than 1. All the other terms are same, RC by R is same, 2IG is the same. So this thing is less than the option number C. So option number C will have maximum current range. That means the answer will be Bombay and Calcutta.